Good morning, Kids for Jesus and church family. Last week we spoke about seeing and how we are able to see differently when we accept Jesus' invitation to come. This week we are speaking about being different. Last week seeing, this week being. The Very Hungry Caterpillar by Eric Carle. In the light of the moon, a little egg lay on a leaf. One Sunday morning, the warm sun came up and pop! Out of the egg came a tiny and very hungry caterpillar. He started to look for some food. On Monday, he ate through one apple, but he was still hungry. On Tuesday, he ate through two pears. But he was still hungry. On Wednesday, he ate through three plums, but he was still hungry. On Thursday, he ate through four strawberries, but he was still hungry. On Friday, he ate through five oranges, but he was still hungry. On Saturday, he ate through one piece of chocolate cake, one ice cream cone, one pickle, one slice of Swiss cheese, one slice of salami, one lollipop, one piece of cherry pie, one sausage, one cupcake, and one slice of watermelon. That night, he had a stomach ache. The next day was Sunday again. The caterpillar ate through one nice green leaf, and after that, he felt much better. Now he wasn't hungry anymore. He wasn't a little caterpillar anymore. He was a big, fat caterpillar. He built a small house called a cocoon around himself. He stayed inside for more than 2 weeks. Now, for today's lesson, I'm going to need you to use your imagination. Can you do that? All right, let's close our eyes because today we are becoming caterpillars. Yes, caterpillars. Can you picture it? All right, what has happened? Suddenly, the world has gotten so big around us because we are so small. How would the trees look? How would the leaves look? How would the grass look all around us? And if we took a look at our caterpillary selves, how would we look? Would we have spots or stripes or spikes? We'd suddenly have lots of little legs. And maybe suddenly we'd be a little bit nervous because what if someone squished us? Or what if a bird swooped down and plucked us away? Now, the cool thing about a caterpillar is a caterpillar knows exactly what it needs to do just naturally. A caterpillar knows it needs to eat, it needs to be safe, and it can only go at a very slow pace. Caterpillars love flowers, and I believe that some even have a sweet tooth and enjoy honey. But caterpillars also know that they need to become butterflies. It seems almost impossible that a squiggly, wiggly, creepy crawly can become something so beautiful. You know, as a caterpillar, you need to become a butterfly. But you might think you don't know. You might think it's too complicated. You might think that you might make a mistake if you try. Or what happens if you turn into something else. Once you become a butterfly, you will see things so differently. You will fly above the grass and the trees and the flowers. You will be able to avoid danger because you can move faster and you can travel far distances. But to become a butterfly, you need to change. You need to be something else. Now, how will that happen? Will it be easy? Even if you figure out how to spin your cocoon, it might be dark inside and a little bit scary. You might not want to do it at first, but you know that you need to. It is something new, something you've never done before. But after a while, you might like your cocoon. It's warm and it's dark and it's safe. You're comfortable and you're happy. So when it's time to leave your cocoon, you might not want to. Why would you? It's safe. But if you never leave your cocoon, you will never be a butterfly. You need to grow and escape from your comfort zone. You need to break out and become what or who God created you to be. Now, our Bible story for today is a little bit confusing, just as it was for Nicodemus.
This Bible reading is from John chapter 3, verses 1 to 8. Jesus teaches Nicodemus. Now there was a Pharisee, a man named Nicodemus, who was a member of the Jewish ruling council. He came to Jesus at night and said, "Rabbi," which means teacher, "we know that you are a teacher who has come from God. For no one can perform the signs you are doing if God were not with him." Jesus replied, "Very truly I tell you, no one can enter the kingdom of God unless they are born again." "How can someone be born when they are old?" Nicodemus asked. "Truly they cannot enter a second time into their mother's womb to be born." Jesus answered, "Very truly I tell you, no one can enter the kingdom of God unless they are born of water and the Spirit. Flesh gives birth to flesh, but the Spirit gives birth to spirit. You should not be surprised at my saying, you must be born again. The wind blows wherever it pleases. You hear its sound, but you cannot tell where it comes from or where it is going. So it is with everyone born of the Spirit."
How can we be born again? We are born into God's family as humans. One way, all the same way. But we can't become the people God wants us to be if we don't become butterflies. We're born into God's family, brothers and sisters with Jesus, but the choice is ours. We need to want to be different. Knowing how to be born again is actually already inside of us. It seems complicated. It seems tricky and maybe a little bit scary. But just like the caterpillar knows how to become the butterfly, we know how to be born again. It might take time, and we might struggle with it a little bit at first. But once we see differently, we can be different. And then we can fly.
Then he nibbled a hole in the cocoon, pushed his way out, and
he was a beautiful butterfly.